These days, as you can imagine, I've had a lot of time on my hands. And so I figured a good way to make the most out of that time would be to learn a new language. And I decided to learn Brazilian Portuguese. Now, why did I pick Brazilian Portuguese? How did I arrive at that conclusion? Well, the short answer is that I'm obsessed with Portuguese music. I absolutely adore Portuguese music. I just feel like the language was tailor-made for music, especially music of a certain genre. But that's a whole different conversation for another day. Additionally, I'm just intrigued to see what it's like to learn the language because I may be wrong, but I feel like it isn't as popular as, say, French or Spanish or Italian or even Japanese or Mandarin in terms of people's interest levels or willingness to learn the language. So Portuguese has naturally held that fascination for me. And for some reason, I've always felt like Portuguese is the odd one out of the bunch of French, Italian, and Spanish. I don't know why. But it's interesting that these are all Romance languages, so I'm really keen to find out if my knowledge of French, which I speak decently well, will help me in learning Portuguese. But the interesting and challenging component of this whole thing is that I'm giving myself just 10 days to learn Portuguese. I don't expect to come out of the 10 days fluent, but the point is just to see how much I'm able to learn. And at the end of the 10 days, I'll be having a conversation with my friend Stephanie, who's from Brazil, to see if I'm able to hold a conversation in Portuguese and to see how much I've learned. I've only studied Brazilian Portuguese once in my life, but I don't even know if I should count that because that was many years ago in eighth grade where we had this class called language acquisition that only lasted like 2 months or something. I'm not exactly sure what the point was, but at least I remember one word of Brazilian Portuguese, which is vaca, which is cow. I love Portuguese music and I do listen to it frequently, so I have learned a few words like obrigado, saudade, I'm still a beginner, so that just shows that I am learning this language completely from scratch. So this is what I'm putting myself through. I don't even know what to expect. I've never done anything like this before, but let's just see how this whole thing goes. My first course of action was to do some research and write down a few essential Portuguese words, words that are more likely to be used in everyday speech. Then I headed over to Duolingo to start some lessons. At first, the exercises were way too easy. But as I went further, the vocab and pronunciation got really tricky.
Casa.
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 Eu tenho carro.
Eu tenho carro. Eu tenho carro.
Eu tenho carro.
Eu
bebo leite.
Wow, I'm on level one.
Thankfully, Portuguese uses the same alphabet as English. But the only difference is the use of accents to modify some letters and slightly change their pronunciation. Portuguese vowel pronunciation is composed of open, closed, and nasal sounds, depending on the oral adjustments made when speaking. For example, in the word coração, the first A, which is pronounced A, is pronounced differently from the second A, which has a nasal un sound to it. Small details like this can be a bit confusing or difficult to practice, but it's all quite interesting, really.
I think I'm at that point now where I need to broaden my strategy a bit. There's only so much Duolingo can help with, especially in the area of pronunciation and conversation. So I think it's time I head to YouTube for some instruction in that area. So I found this YouTube channel called Speaking Brazilian Language School, and I clicked on this video called Easy Survival Phrases in Portuguese. I think this should be very useful.
Nós falamos sobre expressões de sobrevivência relacionadas a cumprimentos.
Oh, this is perfect. This would really help me practice. I like the personal touch of being taught by a native speaker and being able to see them. And it seems like the lessons are quite detailed and very easy to absorb, so that's amazing. I'm learning a lot of new verbs and adjectives, and it's nice to be given explanations of how and when to use them. So this is great. I highly recommend this for anyone trying to learn Brazilian Portuguese.
One of the key components of learning a new language successfully is incorporating elements of that language into everyday life. So, I began to speak Portuguese to myself as much as I could, substituting English words for the Portuguese equivalent if I knew it. I also made it a necessity to listen to Portuguese music every single day and pay even closer attention to the words. And I started watching The Circle Brazil on Netflix, which really exposed me to the colloquial language and culture. With a daily two-hour routine of Duolingo lessons and speaking Brazilian lectures, as well as my own separate practices, I started to get somewhere.
You know how people say that once you start dreaming in a second language, then that means you're more proficient or basically fluent in the language, something like that. Well, last night I did not dream in Portuguese because I'm not at that level yet. But thanks to the constant practice of the language and research about Brazilian culture I've been doing, I had a dream that I was in Brazil experiencing Carnival in Rio. And I'm not kidding about this, it was so surreal. I've never been to Brazil before, but this, it just blew my mind. I woke up and I was just like, wow. But anyway, today I'm just going to spend the day tidying up my pronunciation, making sure I have the little things down. And yeah, we're almost there at the end, but I think we've made a lot of good progress.
Eu tenho pouco de fome.
Eu tenho pouco de fome.
A palavra número 86.
So, 10 days have come and gone, and that means today is the day I get to put my skills to the test. I'm just hoping and praying I remember everything I've studied because I'm so nervous. I have no idea how this is going to go, but this is the best way to practice, so let's just jump right in and see where this conversation goes. Olá, Stephanie, tudo bem?
Olá, Richard, tudo bem, e você?
É bom? That's good. How do you say that?
Oh yeah. Isso é bom. Isso é bom.
Okay. Okay.
Onde você está?
What is the verb? Is it eu? Like I am.
It would be eu estou.
Eu estou in Houston, os Estados Unidos.
Que legal.
Eu estou com meu família. Como se diz cousins?
Primos.
Eu estou com meus primos.
Sim.
Você fala outra idiomas?
Idioma is like, is it okay if I correct you?
Oh yeah, definitely. Correct me anytime you want.
Idiomas is a feminine word as well. So you would say like, outros. Oh, I mean, it's a masculine word.
Okay.
I know it with an A, but it's a masculine word.
Okay.
So it would be, você sabe outros idiomas?
Eu não sei. Eu quero aprender francês.
Estou tentando.
Mas ainda não sei. Só um pouquinho.
Para mim, eu gosto aprendi idiomas.
Sim.
Porque é bom aprender sobre culturas. About cultures. Is that correct?
Sim, correto. Você gosta de aprender.
You're gonna notice with the usage, but in English you just say like, I like to learn. For example, in Portuguese you would say, eu gosto de aprender. It would be like the two. I like to learn, eu gosto de aprender.
It's like the infinitive, right? Like you have to put the full verb, not conjugated at all. Okay.
Yes.
Para mim é difícil como a pronunciação. Pronunciação, por exemplo, G, o D, e T, o...
Sim.
Você me contou, você me disse isso. É algo relacionado ao sotaque.
Sotaque.
Sotaque is accent, right?
Yes.
But most of the times it's very intuitive. You just, with the usage of the language, you're going to notice like words in which you could like use the G or the D.
Yeah.
Very like intuitively, I guess. I don't know if there's a rule for that, but there actually isn't.
Qual é o seu prato brasileiro favorito?
Essa é difícil. Eu gosto muito de comer. bom, brasileiro, porque eu gosto muito de macarrão.
Macarrão is like, é italiano.
Mas brasileiro, eu gosto do tradicional. Arroz, feijão e carne. Churrasco. Essa é a minha comida brasileira preferida. Bem diferente do churrasco americano. Mas é muito bom. Muito gostoso. Do you know that word? Gostoso?
Like tasty.
Yes,
yeah.
Very good.
Yeah.
Muito bom.
Qual é o seu prato favorito de cozinha?
Eu diria a minha... Eu vou falar o nome em português. Macarrão de forno. É um macarrão que você faz primeiro e depois você coloca... You put no forno with cheese, com queijo, pepperoni, calabresa. You put it in the oven and it's so good. Macarrão de forno.
O que você vai jantar hoje?
Sopa. Porque minha mãe cozinhou, minha mãe fez uma sopa muito boa. Sopa de feijão.
Feijão.
Let's see if you know that. Feijão is beans.
Beans, oh, ok.
Yeah, e você?
Eu não sei. Provavelmente...
Realmente
arroz e frango.
Ok, that's good. Yeah. I love that.
Como você aprendeu inglês?
Eu morei.
What is that?
Morei. It means I live.
Oh, okay.
Or you could also say eu vivi.
Mas nós usamos muito mais eu morei. Like I lived. Nos Estados Unidos, like you.
Okay.
Por 3 anos.
3 years.
Yes. Com a minha família. So that's how I learned. I'm very, very proud.
Because you actually
worked on this. Portuguese is not very easy. It's actually very hard. Native speakers don't know how hard it is. But for a person to learn Portuguese is a lot harder than learning English, for example. You probably know that English is easier, right? Is it? I don't know.
I guess it always depends on like which one. If you're a native speaker, you won't always realize if it's easy or not, you know?
Being Brazilian and stuff, like I think it's hard sometimes. Sometimes I can't like conjugate some verbs. And I think that in English, it was simpler for me because there's just past, future, and, you know, present, and past continuous. And It's just everything is simpler. It's easier. It's also good for me because I'm practicing my English as well. And my ability to like teach something, that's very nice.
Okay, Ru, is to visit, visitar, I don't know, is it?
What
that's
is good, the, visitar.
Visitar, okay. Eu quero visitar Brasil.
Nice! Yeah.
Quando você vier visitar, tell me, me conta. Talvez podemos nos encontrar.
Muito obrigado, muito obrigado.
De nada.
Yeah. Tchau.
Tchau, foi muito bom.
Obrigado.
I actually think that went pretty well. I mean, for someone who's just been learning for 10 days, I don't think I did badly at all. And I'm happy that this was a conversation as well as a lesson, it felt like. Stephanie gave me a lot of great pointers about pronunciation or just vocab words, so I'm really happy about that. And like I said at the beginning, the point of this wasn't to come out fluent, but just to see how much I could learn. But my journey with Brazilian Portuguese is not just going to end there. I plan to continue to learn the language, practicing as much as I can whenever I can. And I'm interested to see how I'm able to progress as the weeks, months, even years go by. But this whole process has just given me a deeper appreciation for language learning in general, especially when it comes to teaching an absolute beginner a new language. Devising lesson plans and making sure they actually understand and learn the language is a lot of work. So if you're able to teach yourself a language from scratch, you should be proud of yourself because a lot goes into it, and I think sometimes people don't realize how much goes into learning a second language. But this was so fun. I'm so happy I did it. I learned so much, and I actually think that of all the languages I've learned, Portuguese is my favorite one. And now I can't wait to tell people that I can speak Portuguese as well. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you soon. Ciao.
Tem ou tem?
Tem.
Mais devagar, por favor.
Pode. Você falar inglês? Você falar inglês?
Ela é uma menina e eu sou um menino.
What?
Como se soletra água?
Como se soletra água?
O que significa? Água.
O quê?
Entendi. Ou não entendi.
Não entendi.
Tenho uma casa. Tenho uma casa.
It kind of sounds like Zulu to me.
I feel like a lot of these phrases that I'm learning, I'm going to have to cram them instead of learning them properly to the point where I know what I'm saying. Because it's, I don't know.